We are talking about new risk factors in patients with heart failure, and more especially the role of the calcitriol, vitamin D125, for the risk stratification. So what we observe is that the heart failure patient exhibits lower levels of 125 vitamin D. This group of patients, what we observe is a significant relationship between the decrease of vitamin D125 and the risk of cardiovascular death over a long time follow-up, 6 years. And what we also observe is the significant relationship with the disease severity, but also established biomarker of vascular remodeling. Our study population was heart failure patient with reduced left ejection fraction. We cannot systemize to all heart failure patients. We will have to demonstrate the efficiency of the ratio in patients with preserved ejection fraction, and maybe in group of higher risk of heart failure like hypertension and type 2 diabetes. Okay, that's important because previously we reported secondary hyperparathyroidism in heart failure. Then we observe the rise of the fibroblast growth factor 23, and then we go deeper in the analysis with the other player, the vitamin E125. It's not just risk biomarkers. What our hypothesis is also the possibility to supplement heart failure patient with calcitriol and then increase the levels and decrease soft endpoints like the biomarkers related to vascular remodeling, but also to maybe on longer haul the risk of cardiovascular death. What was new in our study is a ratio between the vitamin D125 levels and the PTH. And you know they are both interplay, so we are improving the risk stratification by using the ratio. I think that secondary hyperparathyroidism is a condition dealing with endocrinologists, nephrologists. That's new fields for heart failure specialists. We heard a lot here about also FGF23 interrelated to what we observe. So I think that we are clearly in this field of disturbances of bone and mineral metabolism in heart failure patients and in cardiovascular diseases. We are knowing more and more about these disturbances with concrete implications for more personalized care of heart failure patients. We are in the quest of more precision medicine, more personalized therapy. We are here subphenotyping heart failure patients with simple biomarkers which can clearly help to the more personalized care.